so you want to design and 3D print products that actually sell. Well, let me tell you how I go about doing this. It's relatively simple. All you really have to do is find a problem that is to a specific niche, solve that problem, and then sell that solution. Of course, it's a little bit more complicated than that, so let's get into it. First and foremost, you're looking for a problem. Now, what type of problems are you looking for? I'm going to show you a problem with this AeroPress right here and my entire solution pipeline for it. I'm not going to sell it at the end, but it's a good example nonetheless. So when it comes to problems, everybody, the first thing you think is, I want to create a product that's going to solve a problem for everyone. And that is because it's for everyone, that means everyone is going to want to buy it. That also means that it is very expensive to market and almost impossible to actually do proper marketing to it, because you're just trying to sell it to everyone. I know it's a little bit counterintuitive, but trust me, I've been doing marketing for over a decade, and everything that is marketed for everyone has always failed in my book. You have to niche it down to some sort of topic or profession. So it could be laser cutting, dog walking, jogging, it could be woodworking, it could be cooking, it could be just something that's niched down. So for instance, for my example, this is niched down. It's for people that are going to have an AeroPress, who are coffee enthusiasts and want to be on the go. That is very niched down. Now be careful, because you can over niche as well, which means that then the audience pool of who you're trying to sell to might be too small. So try and aim for some sort of hobby and make it day to day, or something that is actually vital that they need to do at some point, and it's just a pain to sort out with. So for instance, I've actually done this before in the past with these teeny tiny little screw guides right here. Now you might have no idea what exactly this screw guide is all about. Well, I own a Glowforge, which is a laser cutter that has an exhaust fan that gets very dirty. And the only way to get that exhaust fan out is by getting quite fiddly in there, taking out some screws to truly be able to clean that exhaust fan. But then putting that back in is almost impossible without these little screw guides. So I decided that I was going to go and design these up. And I've now sold 75 of these without doing any marketing and without actually trying to sell these at all. Now, the reason why I'm trying not to sell these is because I'm actually giving away these files completely for free to that community, because I believe that it's a necessity that they actually need to do. So I'm trying to do this more as a service to help people out. But that's an idea of a product that is needed for a niche that sells well. People buy this for £12. These two little things, they only take me about 20 minutes or less to 3D print. But then there's the whole point of me cleaning it up and also doing the postage. But it's a service here, not really a product to sell, but just letting you know that this is an idea of what would actually sell well. So let's get to my problem that I'm going to show you that I have a solution for. So my problem is right here. My AeroPress, I love it. I go all over the place with this. In fact, to and from home and work. And I have all of these filters that I need to take with me. Now, to make a coffee with an AeroPress, you basically put a filter inside of this little cap right here, then you fill the top bit up here with coffee, then you put in hot water, put the plunger, wait a little bit, and then press that plunger down and you have a delicious coffee. But if I want to take this on the go, I have to take all this with me as well. Well, in reality, all I really need to take is the amount that I'm going to need for the day, about that. Now, there is a very simple solution to this. I just whack it in there and that's it, done. But then what happens when I'm cleaning? What happens when I don't want these to get lost or something along those lines? Okay, so there is my problem, and it is a niche because it is just for this. So what's the number one thing you should do straight after you've sort of found a problem? Research it. See if other people have this problem. And more than anything, see what solutions are already out there. I can tell you right now, for this problem that I have with the AeroPress, there are solutions for it. In fact, you just go to Thingiverse, type in AeroPress filter holder, and there are. There's a whole bunch. But you know what? The requirements that I want, which is just to be able to stack a couple of these actually inside right here, well, there's nothing for that. There's only much bigger systems that hold a whole bunch of filters or that give you a cap to fill this up in there. Anyway, those are all the other solutions, but there isn't one that fits what I would consider a solution. So that right there means that there's a little gap in the market. So that is what I'm going to go and aim for. Now, this is exactly the same for any other problem out there. You've just got to figure out, is this really solving the problem? Is it solving it the best way possible? Is there a way that you could improve on that solution? And then from there, you jump over into the next step, which is brainstorming. This is the part of idea generation. Now, I struggle here and I don't follow my own advice very often, but this is my advice. I know you might already have the idea in your head. You might already know the perfect solution, but I'm going to tell you, put it down as one of the three. You always have to think outside of the box. Why are you not doing the other ideas that are out there? Why not go at this at a completely different angle? And then when you're doing these idea generations, make sure you're really keeping in mind the requirements. Now, requirements can be everything from strength, flexibility. Does it have to be food safe, heat resistant? Does it have to look cool? Does it have any other function or form that is a necessity to the product? At that point, then you're now doing ideas that come into the realm of your actual solution. So for instance, for me, I have the AeroPress. So the first idea I have, yes, I know, I want to create this sort of double collar here. I have one collar and then the other collar, so this fits onto this collar. The new product collar goes onto there, and then I have a little bit of space because right this minute, if I tried to put filters just straight on there, this wouldn't actually be able to turn. So my first solution is that collar. Okay, now I have to force myself think, okay, another solution. Well, I only want to carry just a few of these. So what about just a clip that holds this onto there? Okay, that is an idea. And then what about, instead of just having them in there, just willy-nilly like that I'm not really happy with, how about putting this in some sort of a capsule or a dispenser that fits in here? And then when I'm actually wanting to make a coffee, I take that dispenser out and put that off to the side. So this holds these nice and neatly. And then I have my entire AeroPress. Now, I would say, come up with your three ideas. After you have your three ideas, do the pros and cons really of them. And if you really can't think of any other ideas, go and grab the other solutions. Think, what is this other solution not solving? What is the pro and con of this solution over the idea that I have right now? Why didn't they go the way that I did? Now, of course, there is a very big step here that we have not actually thought about, which is manufacturing and the process of manufacturing. Because now that you have all the requirements, you can actually add the manufacturing into this before you actually finalize a design, because that is going to really dictate, especially for 3D printing, be it FDM, be it SLA, be it powder-based metals, whatever it is you're doing. It's going to tell you what your design is going to need. Is it going to be needing support? Is it going to need heat-resistant material? Are you needing to make it food-safe in some way? Which, by the way, that's pretty hard to do with 3D printing nowadays. So, think there. That there is brainstorming. Once you've done the brainstorming, that's when you go into the design process. Now, in the brainstorming, I like to do a whole bunch of jotty stuff. Remember, any sketch is better than no sketch at all. I sometimes like to just jump straight into Blender and do all of my doodles in there instead. I sometimes like to download what the other solutions are, if they are CC0, and then chop them up, remix them, really break them to fit my solution, and then from there create a nice clean model. But of course, make sure that you have the permission, make sure that it's CC0. Don't just copy somebody else's files. That's just a big no-no. Then comes the fun one, which is the actual designing of it. And designing is sort of pretty simple. All you're going to do is design it, test it, create it, develop it, and do that all again. Sorry, I meant to say test, develop, create, test, develop, create. You're rapid prototyping. You have your own 3D printer. Do what it was literally made for. And there you have it. It's pretty much that simple. And I know I'm saying it's simple, but you've already done the hard work in the first two steps. That initial problem finding and that initial solution is the key thing. It isn't actually the designing of the product. It's actually the finding of the problem and the solution that fits the problem correctly. Now, of course, there's so much more. There's marketing, there's branding, there's how exactly are you going to do all of that. And that is an entire beast in itself. And I'm more than happy to let you know more about that. But let me know down in the comments if that is something that you'd be interested in. So now that I've shot down the designing step completely, let me just quickly go through it. I pretty much just grab myself some files online that are CC0 and that actually already have all the measurements that I need. If not, I would really suggest getting yourself some metal calipers, because this is exactly what you're going to be needing. The plastic ones sometimes have a bit of give and that doesn't give you accurate results. Remember to keep in mind 3D printing tolerances as well as 3D printing design principles like overhangs and all of that. If you want to know more about that, I would also like to hear that down in the comments, and I'm always happy to make more videos to help you guys out. Editing Jonathan here. So as you've seen, this has actually already been created, but don't worry, everything that I just said applies pretty much exactly the same. In fact, to the point that I could actually redesign this now for different manufacturing processes to see if there's a way that I could even improve on this design in some way after I've tested it myself. Now, I'm not about to reinvent the wheel here, so if you want to get the link to the exact one that I'm talking about, it's linked down in the description. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and it means the world to me. Without you, I truly would not have been able to make Maker Tales. A big thank you to my VIP makers, Jem Ostkanak and David Fernandez. And if you're enjoying what I'm making here and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. And by the way, if this is the first time you're jumping into 3D modeling and 3D design for 3D printing, I have an entire free course here on YouTube that teaches you Blender, all the technicalities of 3D modeling with Blender, or if you want to learn Blender through actual 3D printing product projects, then head on over to Maker Tales Academy, and that's down in the description away. Anyway, thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.